He's got 100 that he'll never forget. He's got 100 that all those here at Trent Bridge will never forget.
Yep, he's finally got one through. But this time he didn't try and crash it. Brendan McCullen caressed that, didn't he? The very full wide half volley. Didn't need to do anything, just make sure he got the bat on it. Well bowled. He's bowled really well, Stephen Finn. He really has. He's in his third over. Cut him in half there. Oh, that's gone quick. He thought that was one or two to fine leg, but fine leg square, and it's raced along for four. Well, these two have got the team to 42 for none, for 7.5 overs. So they're doing very nicely with all the wickets in hand. Oh, that's half volley. Yeah, that's just annoying. You nearly get him out. The next ball, it clatters you for four.
That's lovely timing from Goptil. Just a little push. Look at that racing away. Poor, flat, just carries for six. They moved the rope back actually a little bit just before play, but still gone all the way. McCullen with bat speed and intent. It's probably safe, chipped into a big space on the leg side. In fact, never mind being safe, he's gone over the ropes. Well, that's a good idea. That's, well, it's the keeper who's taken the catch, but Wood was certainly asking the odd question. Safe hands this time of Butler, and a very important breakthrough because these New Zealand openers were getting away with it.
Well, you can't buy this wicket-taking talent. Mark Wood has come on time after time this summer and picked up an important wicket. He hurries the ball off the surface, he hits the seam, he bowls mainly good lines. McCullum livid with himself because he'd set his stall out to play a longer sort of innings here. Oh, Mark Wood's definitely got something. He's the selector's find of the moment. McCullum, 35 from 31 balls, it's 88 for one. Well, there's no stopping that. We've been talking about how hard the ball is hit. Often unorthodox, but also orthodox. Oh, what a lovely way to go to 50. Consummate innings from Martin Guptill. That's a very difficult catch for somebody, and they've caught it. Whoever that somebody is deserves a medal and more. Steve Finn, the big fella, with a great grab.
Well, England have dropped three, two of them easy. Stephen Finn dropped the hard caught ball, and then he's caught an absolute corker, hasn't he?
Big prize too, Guptill, 53, it's 116 for two.
Well, that's going to be four again for New Zealand. Good foot movement again from Williamson, and he makes it into a full toss. Through the eye of a needle once again from Williamson. He's not timed it, but it's just pure placement. And the 50 partnership from 50 balls. We're four matches into a five-match series, and already this pair have scored over 600 runs between them. Another 50 for Kane Williamson. He just makes batting look so simple. 39 balls, 8 fours. He's well on the way to another century.
That's probably a big one. It's coming up towards the commentary box, and he's bided his time, Williamson. Just chipping them into the outfield, but then gave it the full meat of the bat. That's a class shot. Beautiful use of the feet. Just getting his body outside the leg stump and aligned to hit that one over extra. Might be close and is out. Rob Bailey gives him out. So that's the way to part them, is to bowl straight.
Finn's had a pretty good day. Not his best, but pretty good. Ross Taylor goes for 42. It's 217 for three.
Oh, well, is it that? He's had enough. Grand Elliott has been poking and prodding around. Slog is out. Oh, well caught. Well caught. England have dropped a few. And the danger man Williamson has gone. What a catch there by Adil Rashid.
That, in a way, was not the ideal ball. Felt like a length ball that Williamson had just pummeled away for four, but that time just didn't quite get the elevation on it. Maybe it just tucked him up a bit on middle and off stumps. Just got a bit too much bottom hand and he couldn't get it over the top of the stretching Rashid. And Williamson departs for an excellent 90.
It's in the air, Ronke. Just an effortless flick to the onside. Stephen Finn into his last over, he's been very good today. Try in the slot. Terrific strike from Elliott, he needs that. He's struggled so far today. Simple chance, yeah. Easy one for Ben Stokes and the dangerous Ronke goes.
Stop the momentum of Ronke, who just come in and can take sides apart. He's gone for eight, 271 for five.
Four more. Right in the slot. First 50 of the series for Grant Elliott. 45 balls, 4 fours, 3 sixes. Well, this is a gamble by England to leave Rashid till the end of the innings. And there's the first ball into the stands. Hitting with the breeze, Santner. It's a good strike. Take that, six more. That's huge. Well, that's going to be six more. He's just got enough of it. Three and four balls for Santner. Well, that's the biggest of them all. That's going to hit the TV screen. That is a monster. And what an over for New Zealand. 28 runs from it. Now, that's going to be out. Straight to Sam Billings on the cover point boundary and relief for England.
Well, that was a marvellous gem of a late innings by Santner. 44 off 19 balls. It may have holed out, but I'll tell you what, New Zealand will take that anytime. 342 for six.
Another one, hitting into the breeze. No, the breeze holds it up and a brilliant catch from Ben Stokes. Only four so far from this final Rashid over. And it's a good finish for Adil Rashid. He had gone for 28 in his previous over. First four, and it's a good one for Alex Hales, picking up length quickly.
Oh, hello. That's what he does for Surrey, that's why he's picked by England.
Very good from Hales, he's quite picked the gap. Ah, well, maybe he has. Because the parry works. The parry doesn't work.
6.
Thank you very much. There's a nice little momentum here for England.
Tell you what,
make it 12.
Excellent pickup again from Hales. It's his favourite shot. McLennigan into the attack, but it's the same damage being done. Bit of fortune and a 50 up for Alex Hales. 32 deliveries, 7 fours, 2 sixes. Huge! It's a monster, it really is. Top tier. Well, there's one ball remaining of McLennigan's first over. He's already gone for 16. Make that 22. Got him, a drag on from Alex Hales. He's just continuing to try and hit with the breeze. Crucial wicket for New Zealand.
And England 100 for 1 of 10.4 overs. Wonderful.
Wow. Very similar to the shot that Alex Hales got out to. Jason Roy just stayed that little bit stiller. Out. Smash to extra cover. Good catch for Williamson. And Henry gets his second.
Well, this is the difference. England dropped a number of catches. This went quite sharp, out of the meat of the bat. He'll be a little disappointed with that, thinking he hit it very well, but hit it at the man. And this might be the difference between win and lose, because this is on for England. But if New Zealand catch the catches, that's a good one. Then it makes a hell of a difference. 38 of 35 balls, 111 for 2 now, England.
Ah, lovely start for the England captain. He's in really good form.
Oh, down the pitch and out of the park. Whoop, that's safe, the big bats. Carries it, don't hit it perfectly, but he's hit it pretty well, it's 6 more. So he always chassés to leg, to give himself rooms to free his arms. He's a good striker in good form.
Excellent, just using the pace of Williamson. 57 miles an hour is quick for a spinner. And Joe Root realised it and just glided it into that space. 50 for Joe Root. Excellent batting once again from England's number 3 in one day cricket. Now the score's now 198 for 2 after 25 overs, and you have to say this pair are making this chase of 350 look very, very comfortable. Very similar to Kane Williamson for New Zealand. He gave it the right-hand version of hitting the ball over extra covers. There's the left-hand version. Watch how still Morgan is on the shot. Brilliant stroke, fast hands. And it's the fourth 50 of the series for Owen Morgan. And the 100 partnership between this pair. Well, he's got hold of that, Owen Morgan. Is it enough? Not quite.
That's a gem. So nice to see Owen Morgan play that straight. Oh, runs here. Oh, that's a cracking shot. Joe Root stays in the shot so well. Another thrashed out the ground. I really think Morgan's enjoying himself here. It's like a series of innings that get rid of a lot of stress that emanated throughout the winter. See if anybody can catch it. Nope. It's too far for anybody to catch. Those ground staff people are down there. It's so straight that the crowd can't get to it. Brilliant. It really is brilliant. This is the night to savour. England on the cusp. He's got it. He's got 100 that he'll never forget. He's got 100 that all those here at Trent Bridge will never forget.
Well, Alex Hales and Jason Roy started it off, but Morgan's finishing it in style. Yeah, it's a very special 100 today he's made. Four runs to root, nice square drive. It's just sort of batting practice now. That might be out. And finally, Morgan perishes. Bit of a tame end, actually. Just seemed to get a bit of a top edge. Maybe, understandably, a little tired, but the crowd rise to him. That is an outstanding performance. A continuation of the excellent form he's shown throughout this series, leading from the front and playing an innings of true skill and ingenuity.
Every single game we keep seeing innings and saying it doesn't get any better. Well, that's right up there as well. Made it look so easy. 113 off 82 balls. England now 309 for three.
Top edge now. Is this a chance? It's a difficult one. He can't get there. And Root gets back for two. It's a century for Joe Root. How many times have we said that in the last 12 months? Well, eight actually, in all formats of the game. So consistent. So often does he seem to get three figures, it barely seems to be a story anymore. Fluent and wristy and composed. Another excellent innings. Oh, now Ben Stokes joins this six-hitting party.
Well, there's vengeance in that. It's almost as if he's doing it for Adil Rashid. I think we can say England have done it now.
And another one to add to it. 3-3. 14 runs off three balls from the left-arm spin. It's not the end of bowl spin.
The seal on it. It had to be one with a boundary. It had to be won by Joe Root. Believe it, this is a New England. They're expressing themselves and they're delighting the people who pay to come and watch them.
They're all shaking hands. New Zealand know they've been beaten roundly and soundly and emphatically by this reborn England side.